Imagine this. It's 2898 AD, 6,000 years after the Mahabharata. India is a dystopian wasteland. Kashi, once a holy city, is now ruled by a withered dictator from a massive inverted pyramid. Amidst this chaos, a slave woman carries humanity's last hope. The 10th avatar of Vishnu. Sounds wild, right? That's just the beginning. Visuals and world building. First things first, the world of Kalki feels immensely lived in. Not for a moment do you doubt that this city actually exists. The VFX team has outdone themselves. Every frame is a feast for the eyes, from the neon-lit streets of future Kashi to the barren wastelands. When you first see the inverted pyramid looming over the city, you believe in it. It's both breathtaking and terrifying. I guess the best way to describe it would be ancient Indian baby of Blade Runner and Mad Max. Now that we have this world, I hope Nagi ropes in other filmmakers to tell various tales based in this world. The cast, legends and the rising stars. Alright, let's talk about the star-studded cast. Amitabh Bachchan as the immortal Ashwatthama. He's like fine wine, getting better with age. There's a flashback scene set in the Mahabharata era that's pure gold. Kamal Haasan as Supreme Yaskin. Chilling, enough said. Prabhas as Bhairava. Now this is where things get a bit iffy. More on that later. Deepika Padukone as prophesized mother. She should have been the heart of the film, but the script doesn't always treat her that way. And a lot of cameos that keep breaking the illusion. Every few minutes the wife kept asking, who is this? Thankfully, only in the first half. The good, the bad, and the mythological. The way this film weaves Hindu mythology into a sci-fi narrative is fascinating. Ancient mantras working alongside powerful futuristic weapons. It's bonkers, but somehow works. You can see influences from other sci-fi epics like Dune in its epic scale, Children of Men in its dystopian pregnancy plot, and Mad Max Fury Road in its action sequences. But Kalki does not copy ideas, it recreates it, adding in a unique flavor all its own. Yes, it is tropey, but it is in service of building a fantastic world. Though its focus on making its male leads shine at the cost of the female leads is sad. Disha Patani is as listless as ever. Anna Behn's charm is totally wasted, and Deepika Padukone is fighting the script for attention instead of being the center of it all. Technically, the film is a marvel. The cinematography uses many wide shots to showcase the scale, contrasting with intimate close-ups during emotional scenes. The sound design is mind-bending, blending futuristic sounds with traditional Indian instruments. But the music leaves a lot to be desired. The epic scale of the movie is not captured in the soundtrack. It is adequate at best. The action sequences are well executed, especially when Amitabh Bachchan is involved. But there is no sequence that will stay with you after the film is done. Some sequences with Prabhas feel like they walked in from another film and do not belong in Kalki that wants to tackle heavy themes of technology versus spirituality and the role of faith in a godless world. Character deep dive. Bhairava, played by Prabhas, is meant to be our hero, but often feels like a comic relief in a film filled with many other interesting characters. He is cracking jokes while the world is pretty much ending. Supreme Yaskin, portrayed by Kamal Haasan, is complex, terrifying, yet somehow sympathetic. Watch out for his monologue about the burden of immortality. It is a standout moment. I really hope he gets to fire his Gandhi in the sequel. Deepika Padukone's character, the mother, should have been the emotional core of the film, but is sadly underwritten. Her scene in the lab realizing her child's destiny is heartbreaking and shows what the film could have been if her character was given more focus. Amitabh Bachchan's Ashwatthama is the only fully realized character of the film, and he makes you believe in the angry old man. This year, he is going to sweep all the awards. Final thoughts, Kalki 2898 AD is a mixed bag. but it is an important step for Indian cinema. It is not perfect, but it is ambitious, visually stunning, and thought-provoking. It knows what has come before and builds on top of that. Standing on the shoulder of giants, this film takes the genre to new heights. As for the future of this franchise, I'm very optimistic. We are done with the teething troubles, and now we'll see some great stories in Kalki cinematic universe. I hope Nagi ropes in other filmmakers, and we have something even bigger than Star Wars. So, what do you think? Is Kalki 2898 AD the future of Indian cinema, or just another overblown spectacle? Let me know in the comments. And if you enjoyed this deep dive, don't forget to
like, share, high five, subscribe, let our channel thrive.